And it's like you said, he had to go war. They had extra toes and fingers even.
Yeah.
But he had to go war against them to possess something that he had already seen here, but he wanted something he hadn't seen.
That's right.
What did he say in Joshua chapter 2? Sanctify yourselves, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you. And they crossed over. It's time, Mr. Businessman, Mrs. Businesswoman, that you sanctify yourself.
Amen.
Gird up the loins of your mind. Cross over your Jordan. Begin to operate in the gift of faith and the move of the Spirit of God.
Yes.
That God has anointed you. He's equipped you for this generation and to take your mountains of influence to the glory of God. God's going to have a capstone generation. God's going to have that final generation that's going to do signs and wonders among us. And I want it to be our generation. How about you?
Yes.
Are you ready? I don't want to wait. I don't want to die in the wilderness. I don't want to wait anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I want it to be this generation. Even so, come quickly. Lord Jesus, the kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and of His Christ and of the increase, it says in Isaiah, of His government of peace. There shall be no end. There's no end to what God can do in your life. There's no end to what God can do with your business. It's a weapon. It's a tool. Hallelujah. But we need to get the ites out of us.
Amen.
We need to get the ites out of us.
Yes.
We can't possess the land if the land is possessing us. We can't possess, we can't kick the enemy off our territory and our boundaries if he's inside of us. Jesus said, the prince of this world is coming and he has nothing in me.
Amen.
And that's one of our purposes is to say he has nothing in us. He has nothing in our leaders. He has nothing in our companies. And we can see the favor break forth. So shall the favor break forth. Like the noonday upon your business.
Yes, in favor. I'll take the favor above everything. I'll take the favor of God.
I want the favor of God. It's
Amen.
The closeness of God.
You can lay, and I can say this from my heart, you can cover this table with $1 million and say you want it, or whatever amount you can conjure up, and say, take this or God's favor.
Yes.
I'll walk away from this because I want that favor.
Hallelujah.
If you got favor, He said, lay your treasures up in heaven.
Mm.
And he said that, and when your treasures are in heaven,
yes,
that's where your heart is.
Yes.
And the heart is your thought. And so whenever you have that in heaven, I'm going to tell you something. God will bless your business. God will bless everything. He will take those things that are not there and make them there. Because what is hope? Hope and faith. Faith, we say faith is tangible, yes. How can it be tangible unless you have hope? What is hope? Hope props faith up.
Yes.
It's like two bookends holding faith in the air. Hope against hope, and faith is propped up. And so whenever you put that ingredients together and start going forward with intercessory prayer, these people in the Bible, Jesus, the Father gave us something. These men like Abraham, Gideon, all these men were written in the heroes of faith. And never received the promise.
There you go.
But seen it afar off and believed it. See, and we got it. And it's hard for us to believe it.
Right.
And we have the promise.
That's right. One of the things that a lot of people need to understand, though, is it's God's design, desire. His everything inside of Him is for giving us or opening the heaven to show us His favor.
Yes.
I mean, His desire is like ours for our kids, but a billion, 6 billion times greater.
Amen.
I mean, our kids just showed up and we loved them.
Uh-huh.
So stop thinking that we got to do something to get them to love us.
Yes.
But there is an order that you can step in that'll open the heavens.
Amen.
And hope